The coronavirus will be a really serious test for the resilience of global supply chains. I think it will be extremely significant, and I will provide two quick arguments. First of all, using a benchmark we have seen in the past, the SARS, and then try to project from it. And then I will try to talk a little about, from a supply chain perspective, how we look at these kind of demand shocks. The SARS is probably the benchmark that we have around, and the impact on the global supply chain was at a certain level, but not as significant as we originally suspected. It was around $60 billion, but right now China is much more significant in the global economy, and we depend on it as a manufacturing hub in many different ways. So China in 2002-2003 was 1.7 trillion, it's 14 trillion right now. It was only 5% of global trade, is around 13% right now. And also as a manufacturing hub, at that point in time, China was low commodities, low-level commodities like textiles and plastics. By this point in time, we are also sourcing high-tech and inputs for high-margin products. So the significance of manufacturing hub of China is much more important in the global supply chains. So we have very serious demand shocks that many industries are going to feel, definitely the airlines, the car industry, Wuhan is the Detroit of China, electronics, semiconductors, pharmaceuticals indirectly through the active ingredients, as 80% of the active ingredients are made in China and significantly some of it around the Hubei province. And of course, we have to be a little concerned about the impact of the trade deal and the ability of the Chinese to deliver on it, the $200 billion over the next few years. So when I try to estimate the impact, I would take whatever I said for SARS, which is $50 billion, multiplied by a factor of 5 to 7, and my estimate, I would say rather a conservative estimate of around $300 to $400 billion, and something that will last twice whatever is the duration of that epidemic. If it's 8 months, then start talking about 2 years before you stop seeing the propagation of these shocks in the global supply chain.